After the destruction of Alpha Halo, a rare human victory, the UNSC would learn of a plot to conquer Earth itself. An estimated 500 ships, under the command of the Prophet of Truth, were gathered in the Tau Ceti system. This was one of the largest Covenant forces ever seen, and was secretly massed only 11.9 light years away from Earth. At the heart of the fleet was the massive Unyielding Hierophant, which served as a command and control station. It resembled two joined teardrops, with a wheel at the center joined by spokes. The massive 10-kilometer vessel was not only responsible for commanding the fleet, but also performing repairs and maintenance. It was fairly clear to Master Chief that if this fleet ever reached Earth, the planet would be easily overwhelmed. Now, just as a note, the battle groups that attack Earth in October of the same year during the events of Halo 2 and Halo 3 are actually separate than what we're talking about here. Those were under the command of Regret.
And we most definitely regret the Corps just blew up our raggedy-ass fleet! Hoorah!
Well, this fleet is under the command of Truth, who kept it a secret. The UNSC devised a plan to take out the station and hopefully the massive fleet as well. This would be known as Operation First Strike. Now, as a bit of background, Master Chief and the other survivors of Alpha Halo had managed to steal a Covenant DDS class cruiser, the Ascendant Justice. Knowing the location of the Covenant Armada, a Spirit dropship was reinforced and jumped through slipspace. Aboard it were Spartans John-117, Fred 104, Will 043, Grace 093, and Linda 058, as well as Cortana. Once the ship arrived, it put out a request for assistance to the Covenant, who hauled the dropship to a repair bay aboard the Unyielding Hierophant. Meanwhile, the Ascendant Justice exited slipspace near the Oort cloud within the system. The Spartans on board the station encountered no resistance, only running into Huragox, which ignored them, and Ungoy, which are easy to avoid. Chief uploads Cortana into the station's computers, and the AI is able to not only download a copy of the station map, but also provides assistance, unlocking doors and watching the Spartans move stealthily for hours through kilometers of piping and conduits. Soon, they reached one of the Hierophant's reactors, which was more heavily guarded than the rest of the ship. As Linda, as she often did, provided covering fire with her sniper rifle, the rest of the team made a 300-meter sprint to the main reactor, engaging grunts, brutes, and elites. Unfortunately, Grace is killed, but the rest of Blue Team survives. After entering the reactor room itself, Cortana is able to set them to explode, and Blue Team attempts to make their way out of the station. However, they were facing many more Covenant reinforcements. With Cortana having broken herself up into multiple pieces and attempting to disrupt station-wide communication, Blue Team drops mines and steals Banshees as Master Chief doubles back in a craft to pick up Linda. By the way, Linda had been dangling upside down from a rope, sniping out Banshee pilots with her rifle in one hand while holding onto the rope with her other. Pretty badass. Blue Team, now unified, although of course without Grace, managed to steal a second dropship, which they used to escape. Back in system, the Ascendant Justice, still commanded by Vice Admiral Whitcomb, detached from the UNSC Gettysburg, which had been picked up at Reach. Whitcomb, as well as Oni Lieutenant Haverson, got the attention of the Covenant by falsely stating that they possessed a Forerunner crystal. They had actually discovered one on Reach, but that was on the Gettysburg. The Covenant, not wanting to fire on and thus destroy a Forerunner artifact, nonetheless moved their fleet around the ship. It was at that time that the Unyielding Hierophant's reactors finally blew, destroying not only the station, but the vast majority of the 500 capital ships massed nearby. All but 12 ships are annihilated by the reactor overload, which, by the way, is the most classic Halo way to possibly die, and the surviving UNSC soldiers are able to return to Earth. Despite the death of Grace, Operation First Strike was one of the most successful battles for the UNSC during the Human Covenant War. However, for the Covenant, even though Earth's impending attack was delayed, the loss of the station and the massive fleet was seen as no more than an insignificant setback. The Prophet of Regret would assault Earth the following month, and Truth would reinforce his forces shortly after. Still, given that the UNSC lost only a Spartan, a captured Covenant ship, while the alien bastards lost nearly 500 ships, ships and the Unyielding Hierophant, it's hard not to get excited about this kind of victory. But that also tells us the size of the Covenant Empire. 500 ships, while still a loss, is not enough to ruin the war effort. If humanity lost 500 ships at any point in the war, they would have been completely done. But that's just my telling of the story, and I've left out a lot of details, especially the specifics around Blue Team's battle through the Unyielding Hierophant itself, as well as, of course, how Chief even got away from Installation 04 in the first place. If you want the full story, I highly recommend listening to Halo First Strike on audiobook. If you're interested, you can go to audibletrial.com/Eckhart's Letter. You'll get 1 free month of Audible, including a free audiobook. Don't enjoy it? Well, you can always return it, but I think you will. Anyway, guys, as always, this has been Eckhart's Letter. Until next time, may the Force be with you.